After a long wait of exactly 3 months, Reese finally introduced the last patch for Automobilista 2, and therefore also ended the title's early access date. From now on, it is available for 37 euros in the Steam store, but only for a short amount of time, as it was originally intended to cost around 60 euros, if not for the Steam summer sale. However, the question that imposes itself is whether AMS 2 is actually worth buying or not. To help you a bit in this process, I'll share my first impressions and general thoughts. I'll categorize this video into several segments. Handling, especially with regards to Project Cars 2, for obvious reasons. Graphics, multiplayer, AI, and finally, a conclusion and general thoughts that didn't fit into any other part at the very end. The engine on which AMS 2 runs is none other than the Madness engine, which was invented by Slightly Mad Studios and simultaneously the foundation of a game called Project Cars 2. Even though this engine had brilliant features, like live track simulation in perfect coordination with simulated weather, its overall handling was generally considered as rather bad, as all cars drove as if the track was constantly covered with a thin layer of ice, which caused the cars to always wobble in between over and understeer, and made them not feel connected to the ground at all. Another issue were the curbs. Every time your wheels touched the curb, there was an uncertainty whether it would A. suck you off track, B. cause an instant spin, or C. let you pass normally. Due to those occasional hiccups, a lot of people were concerned about them transferring directly to Automobilista 2. But did they? My honest answer would be, well, no, but actually yes, so let me elaborate. First of all, the curbs are fine. There are no more unexpected spins or suction zones. They behave as they are supposed to and unsettle your car only if you go full throttle on a curb in a major acceleration zone. Using them in high-speed corners is in 95% of the cases also perfectly fine. The overall handling though is a nice improvement to Project Cars 2, and the Madness engine definitely was utilized much better. Most cars, especially all newer Formula cars, feel amazing to the point where I found myself just sitting there, hot-lapping around most F1 circuits present in AMS 2 for several hours, because it just felt right somehow. The F3s also quickly grew to be my personal favorites. However, the Madness engine's DNA is definitely noticeable in AMS 2. This means that all cars have a tendency to easily oversteer and wobble a bit at corner exits. It is generally more difficult to really drive smoothly, as especially faster corners are more often than not taken in a slide than in a more grippy way. The right way to express this sensation is probably to claim that the cars don't feel 100% connected to the road, but rather about 90 or so. But please, don't let this distract you from Automobilista 2 already, as this is basically just whining on a high level. The handling is nowhere near as bad as in Project Cars 2, and as I said, it's really just this tiny bit of Project Cars 2's DNA that's the sole remainder of an otherwise completely new and fresh game. Graphics wise, there is not really much to say other than these are basically Project Cars 2's graphics, but better and more vibrant. If I had to rate all modern day sims in terms of their graphics, Automobilista 2 is definitely in my personal top 3, together with Assetto Corsa Competizione and GT Sport. The only slight negative that comes to mind is that I always felt like the cars are missing a bit of shininess, I guess, but this is probably just my personal taste and not a general problem. What's also nice is the fact that even mid-end PCs are able to run AMS 2 smoothly at highest settings. I for myself have a GTX 1060 and an i7-7700K, play on the highest settings and only experience slight FPS drops when driving at night in the middle of 20 or so cars. Now, there's one thing where I felt Automobilista 2 is lacking, and this is the multiplayer. To be fair, until this week, only a very limited amount of people owned AMS 2 in its early access phase, which obviously led to a rather unpopulated multiplayer section and many, many empty servers. The race with the highest participation I experienced was about 10 players, where more than half of them would instantly disconnect after first lap incidents. This leads me to my next point, the netcode. After 1.5 months of early access, Risa acknowledged that they had some issues with the netcode, as servers often registered car contact where those involved often had a gap of half a car length or more. Afterwards, some fixes were deployed, which drastically improved the whole situation, but it's still a bit wonky sometimes, which on the other side could also be due to a lot of players racing with 100 ping or more because of the low player count back then. Apart from this, the races I did were mostly decent and I did actually enjoy them. But if the multiplayer stays in its current state, then AMS2's online scene will die in an instant, as there is nothing to grind for and the competitiveness is lacking immensely. At least Reese is aware of this and plans to integrate multiplayer stats similar to those of ACC into AMS2, which would definitely be a step in the right direction, in my opinion. What is also helpful is the fact that there are at least dedicated servers available and everyone can easily set up one for themselves. So if there will be scheduled races per Risa or a rating system in the near future, I can fully imagine a long and healthy lifespan of AMS2's online scene. But if they fail, the game could potentially vanish as fast as it arrived, at least regarding the online player base. Next, let's see how good the AI is and where and in which modes you can compete against it. In AMS2's main menu are 5 modes available: Private Test, which is basically a free practice session for yourself, Single Race, where you can race the AI on any track with any car, Multiplayer, which I covered before, but it's also able to feature AI cars, Time Trial, where I try to set the fastest lap on any track car combination, and finally, the Championship, where Risa has pre-selected some track car combinations and lets you race the AI in a sort of race calendar. At AMS2's first release, the AI had some problems. They were extremely slow into most corners until cars started to split up, poorly judged the space around them, and were generally unpredictable. But the more patches were introduced, the better the AI got. If you watch the background footage somewhat attentively, you surely noticed what I'm talking about. A cluster of cars together still means incredibly slow mid-corner speed by the AI, and they will still occasionally collide with each other, like here for example. But honestly, I was not a single time crashed into by an AI car. So I just leave it here and say that AI is actually pretty raceable in this game, and I enjoyed many great battles with them. As I'm now done with all main topics of this video, it's time for a short final conclusion. Automobilista 2's strengths are the fantastic simulation of Formula cars, the detailed force feedback, and a very colorful, vibrant, and inviting environment. You can truly get lost in the game, as it just feels nice hot lapping by yourself or to race other players if the netcode does its part properly. The multiplayer will also flourish as soon as the player count starts to rise and servers get more populated. But to keep those players from switching titles, a competitive incentive in form of regularly scheduled races by Risa or multiplayer ratings similar to those of ACC need to be introduced. If Risa unexpectedly fails us, there is still the AI you can race against, as they are decently coded. Yes, they still have the classical issues like slow cornering speed if there is little space between cars, but they make a decent impression overall. So is it worth it to buy Automobilista 2, or should I rather buy another sim? Well, you tell me. I'm not going to state you should or shouldn't buy this game. It's ultimately your decision. You now know what my thoughts are about AMS2 and what I think it still misses and where it does a great job. Let's not forget in the end that Reese is a great company and has already done a great job with Automobilista 1, which is in my opinion a great indicator for a bright future of its successor. Now, this is it for my AMS2 review. I hope you enjoyed the video and could get something useful out of it. If so, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!